Listening Library presents Nate the Great and the Sticky Case by Marjorie Weinman Sharmat. Read for you by John Lavelle. I, Nate the Great, was drying off from the rain. I was sitting under a blanket and reading a detective book. My dog Sludge was sniffing it. I was on page 33 when I heard a knock. I opened the door. Claude was there.
I lost my best dinosaur, Claude said.
He was always losing things. This is your biggest loss yet, I said. A dinosaur is huge. How could you lose it?
My dinosaur is small, Claude said. It is a stegosaurus on a stamp. Can you help me find it?
It is hard to find something that small, I said. This will be a big case, but I will take it. Tell me. Where was the stegosaurus stamp the last time you saw it?
It was on a table in my house, Claude said. I was showing all my dinosaur stamps to my friends. The stegosaurus stamp was my favorite.
Who are your friends? I asked.
Annie, Pip, Rosamond, and you. But you weren't there, Claude added.
Good thinking, I said. I, Nate the Great, will go to your house and look at your table. I wrote a note to my mother. Dear mother, I am on a sticky case. When I find something big that is small, I will be back. Love, Nate the Great. Claude and I went to his house. He did not lose his way. He showed me his table. It had stamps all over it.
Here are all of my stamps, Claude said, except for the stegosaurus stamp.
I, Nate the Great, saw a tyrannosaurus stamp. I saw a brontosaurus stamp. I saw an ichthyosaurus stamp. I saw claws and jaws. The stamps were ugly, but that did not matter. I had a case to solve. I had a job to do. Where was the stegosaurus stamp when it was on the table? I asked.
Near the edge, Claude said.
It must have fallen off, I said. I looked on the floor near the table. The stegosaurus stamp was not there. I picked up a stamp and showed it to Sludge. We must look for a lost stamp, I said. Sometimes Sludge is not a great detective. He tried to lick the sticky side of the stamp.
Look!
Don't lick, I said. Sludge and I looked at, over, under and around everything in Claude's house. Then we looked again. We did not find the stegosaurus stamp. I, Nate the Great, turned to Claude. The stegosaurus stamp is not in your house, I said. Tell me, when did you notice the stamp was missing?
After everybody left, Claude said.
Did everybody leave together? I asked.
Yes,
said Claude. Did everybody come together? I asked.
No, said Claude. Annie and Rosamond came to tell me that Rosamond was going to have a yard sale. Then it started to rain. It rained for a long time, so Annie and Rosamond stayed and looked at my stamps. When the rain stopped, Pip came over. He looked at my stamps too. Then they all left together to go to Rosamond's yard sale.
Then I, Nate the Great, must go to the yard sale too, I said. I must speak to everyone who was in the room with the stegosaurus stamp. Sludge and I went to Rosamond's house. Rosamond was standing in her yard with her four cats under a sign. Yard sale. Buy or swap. Are you selling your cats? I asked.
No, Rosamond said. I am selling and swapping empty tuna fish cans, slippers, spare cat hairs, toothbrushes, pictures of milk, spoons, and all sorts of things.
Sludge was sniffing. Do you have a stegosaurus stamp? I asked.
No, Rosamond said. But I saw one at Claude's house near the edge of his table.
Thank you, I said. I started to leave.
Please, buy a cat hair from my yard sale, Rosamond called. They're only a penny each.
I, Nate the Great, did not want a cat hair. But I gave Rosamond a penny. I will buy one cat hair, I said.
I will give you an extra one free, Rosamond said. Do you want hairs from Big Hex, Little Hex, Plain Hex, or Super Hex?
Surprise me, I said. Rosamond took a hair from a box that was marked Big Hex and a hair from a box that was marked Super Hex. She stuck the hairs to a piece of tape.
So you won't lose them, she said.
Sometimes Rosamond has strange ideas. This was one of them.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.